Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Today is Saturday, the 11th of August 2018. My name is Naftali Ranto. As you know, if you are new to this platform, kindly review the previous presentations and for you to be in the same picture with all of us. Today, I'm going to speak about the five emotional stage of network marketing. Five emotional stage of network marketing. In his book, The E-Myth Revisited, Michael Gerber states that entrepreneurs typically face four stages: excitement, fear, fatigue, and depression. While these stages hold true for network marketing, I will suggest that there is a fifth stage, which is the realization. If only someone would have told me that the different stages I would go through as a brand new network marketer, I could have prepared myself and avoided an emotional roller coaster. I'm going to do you a huge favor right now by helping you to understand the psychological and emotional stages we'll go through in network marketing one way or another. Everyone will go through these stages in varying degrees. So it doesn't matter which company you're working with, you will go through these stages. Let's explore these stages from network marketing perspective. Okay, stage number one is excitement. You know the feeling you get when you come across an opportunity that seems so amazing. It's like the answer to all your problems, an opportunity that awakens those dreams of long time ago. The feeling that this is it, I got it at last. The first stage of network marketing happens immediately after your initial belief in the opportunity. This belief in your opportunity creates a genuine feeling of excitement and anticipation as you look forward to what the future holds in store for you. Everybody goes through this excitement stage. After all, why would you join a network marketing company unless you are excited about the possibilities? The key is in understanding that the excitement is only a feeling and will not always last. Think of network marketing like a marriage. When you first meet a girlfriend or a boy of your dreams, you are infatuated with them. The infatuation gives you feeling of being so excited, but over time, those feelings don't always stick around. People who get addicted to this initial feeling of excitement always seems to be jumping around from relationship to relationship, trying to keep the feeling alive. It's the same reason why you see so many people jumping around from one opportunity to another. They never seem to get past this stage one. Does this relate to you? I was also there at one stage and it didn't work. I only start in that stage. So stage number two is fear. This stage is where fear begins to set in and you start to doubt yourself and your opportunity. Doubt is like a cancer to success. If you don't cut it out, cancer sooner rather than later, it will begin to spread. Once fear and doubt start to spread, it's hard to ever recover. The good news is that this is a normal stage. Everyone experiences fear and doubts to a certain degree. Don't think you are abnormal for going through this stage. The important thing to realize is that you don't have to let fear ruin your life. Fear happens when you begin to imagine all the negative outcomes. Your initial belief starts to be eaten away by the inner doubts you have about your ability to achieve your dreams. A whole book could be written about this topic alone, but the bottom line is that you choose either to allow the thoughts of doubts to control you, or you think positively and strengthen your belief in yourself and your opportunity. It comes down to a choice, so you choose what you want. The people that move past this stage were not immune to fear or doubt. They just didn't let it control them. If you let fear control you, it will rob you of your joy of life. Stage number three, fatigue. Once you get past the fear and doubt stage, move into the mundane, lacking interest or excitement. Mundane is the phase where you are actively working your business on a constant daily basis, but nothing seems to be happening. It's all the little things you realize need to be done in order to build the business. As a mother that works from home, you begin to experience fatigue when you are doing the necessary things to build your business. As your children scream in the background, it's when you have been calling people for 3 months straight and haven't found one good leader to work with. Sometimes this stage strikes hardest when you have been doing some meetings for 6 months and they are not any bigger than when you first began. You get tired, it just doesn't seem to be going anywhere. The mundane settles in with the millions and one little thing that wear you out and leave you exhausted. You start wondering if there is any light at the end of the tunnel. The good news is all successful network marketers have gone through this phase. In fact, you will experience this phase on and off all throughout your career. There will be days of triumph where you will feel like you are on the highest mountain top, and then there will be days when you are burned out and feel like quitting. The key is to keep going forward. If you are feeling really fatigued, take some time to relax and recoup, and so that you can hit it hard again. Here is a little saying that keeps me motivated during the times I feel tired and fatigued. It is the ordinary things that you do on a consistent basis that produce extraordinary results. So stage number four, depression. Depending on your personality, depression may happen to you more naturally than others. Depression occurs when you start to encounter obstacles or challenges in your business that you didn't expect or don't feel like you can overcome them. It can also occur as a result of not properly dealing with your fatigue. That is, you're not getting some rest and relaxation. So you need to take some break. This is the stage where a lot of people quit. You might experience this stage within your first 90 days of being in the business, or you may experience depression 5 years into the business. The point is, you are never totally immune from this happening to you. The key is in understanding the obstacles and challenges you will have to face so that you are not surprised when you go through them. As mentioned earlier, most people quit when they face their first set of challenges in any type of business. It's not entirely their fault either. Most of the time, they are not taught what to expect. There will be many more success stories in this industry if people were prepared for all the obstacles that they will need to overcome. Not all obstacles are the same, of course. Some people might even experience different challenges than others. I have listed all the major challenges and obstacles you have to overcome in the first year of network marketing. Small checks at the beginning, that is the first challenge. Remember, I said network marketing is not a get-rich-quick scheme. Well, expect your checks to be small at the beginning. Small checks at the start are normal. I don't know of anyone who started network marketing with huge check rolling in from the very first beginning. Keep reminding yourself of your long-term vision of creating walkaway residual income. The challenge number two, family and friends making fun of you. Come on, we all go through it. You need to get a whole lot tougher than this if this bothers you. People are always going to criticize the ones who actually step outside the norm. They don't want you to succeed because that weakens their own justification for playing it safe. Don't pay any attention to them. They will never experience the true adventure of life because they are always playing it safe. So you cannot live with reservations. Feeling tired and exhausted. This is very real feeling that you most definitely will experience if you stick around in network marketing. Building a business is not easy. However, eventually the sweet taste of victory quickly erases all the memories and hardships you endured to get there. If building a business were easy, then everyone else will do it. The fact that it is hard gives you an advantage. Most people quit because they don't expect any of the obstacles. You will go in expecting a prepared and prepared for them, which means you won't quit. There isn't very much competition when you rise to the top and simply overcoming all the challenges you face. And this brings us to stage number five, realization. This is the best stage of all. It's when you finally begin to realize and experience all the benefits of building your network marketing business. It's what I like to call the payday. Everyone is happy. You reap the harvest you have been so patiently cultivating for months. Sometimes, yes, as mentioned above, when you experience this stage and the taste the sweet victory of success, you will never doubt yourself or the opportunity again. You have to realize that there is no shortcut to this stage. Everyone goes through the four stages above in varying degree before entering into the final stage of realization. So for today, thank you very much for coming around. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you want to start today, please WhatsApp me on 0799-881171. Thank you very much for coming around. My name is Naftali, and I am your servant. As we are doing every day, the training is getting there, so don't give up. Thank you.